Friends, in last video lecture of chapter number 6, we discussed about the characteristic of fuels, their construction, how exactly they work, and different parameters related with fuses. Now, in this lecture, we are going to observe their types, their working, and related with their different functionality. So here we have type of fuses. Basically, we know the fuses, the protective devices. So, protective devices required for AC as well as DC circuit. But DC having don't have different type of supplies. This is a pure DC supply. So that's why there is a pure simple fusing element included fuse can control that circuit. That's why DC fuses don't have different type of varieties of fuse. But in AC fuses, we have low voltage fuse and high voltage fuse. Also, we have switch type fuses in low voltage. First of all, we will understand what are the low voltage fuses. In low voltage fuse type, we have cartridge type fuses, dropout type fuses, rewirable type fuses, and striker type fuses. In cartridge type fuse, we have D type cartridge fuse, link type cartridge fuse. And in link type cartridge fuse also, we have bolted type HRC link fuse and knife blade type HRC link fuse. So basically, for our syllabus, we have to understand or more concentrated on rewirable type fuse and cartridge type fuse. The sub types of this cartridge type fuse are not that much important, but it is very good for your information. Or in future, it may be useful for you. So in low voltage type, basically important type of fuse is cartridge type fuse, dropout type fuse, rewirable type fuse, striker type fuse, and also switch fuse. In high voltage fuse, we have again cartridge type HVHRC fuse, liquid type HVHRC fuse, expulsion type HVHRC fuse. Okay. So here, we observe this HV. This HV means high voltage, and HRC means high rupturing capacity fuses. Means the fuses which having high arc quenching capacity, high current quenching capacity, or it will they can protect our circuit from the very high current. So that's why we use HRC type fuses. Also, they are totally enclosed. So environmental effect is not creating any extra malfunctioning in that type of fuses. So we will look one by one in detail. First of all, low voltage type fuses. A very popular low voltage type fuses, rewirable type fuse, the most commonly used fuse in house wiring. You just see these pictures and you will get going to know that we are using this fuse till today in our houses. These fuses are commonly available everywhere. We know that there is one metallic strip in between the two contacts, and we replace it when the fuse operated. So basically, this fuse type of fuse, rewirable fuse, is also called as KitKat type fuse. We can use, they have huge applications. We can use it from the residential use till to our double pole structure, from where our supply, we take the supply to our residential purpose. Means double pole structure, that means DP transformer located near to your household area. In your colony, you can observe a double pole structure in on which a transformer has been mounted, and from there different circuits, through the different circuits, we carry the current or supply in our household. There also we can use this KitKat type fuse, but there, as the current rating is very high, we will use aluminium as a fuse element, and for residential we use copper as a fuse element. Basically no alloy required there. So this is very commonly available type of fuse. But it having some restrictions, or we can say it is there, the disadvantages of this fuse, like unreliable operation, lack of discrimination, small time lag, Time lag means the operating time. Low rupturing capacity, no current limiting feature, slow speed of operation, risk of flame and fire. Now this risk of flame and fire is happened when, if I will choose, we know that once the fuse get operated, we have to replace their fuse element. That's why we call this fuse as a rewirable fuse. Okay, but because of lack of knowledge, some people are taking the high rating fuse element, copper wire or broad size, in simple words we can say a broad size wire as a fuse element, then it will not going to operate if something happened or short circuit happened or high current will flow the circuit, and that time risk of flame and fire can be there, because the rewirable fuse can be rewired by any person who don't have the technical knowledge. So you have now this knowledge, so always keep in mind that the rewirable fuse element should be having the current carrying capacity or current rating approximately our circuits equal, but not that much more than that. Means if you want to use this fuse for 5 ampere circuit protection, you must have to use a very small wire, copper wire, which having carrying capacity not much more than 5 ampere. How can you take that wire? We have different type of square mm configuration wire available. So 1.2 square mm copper wire, we can use 2 or 3 threads from that 1.2 square mm wires, flexible wires. That's why we have to take 2 or 3 threads. So equally they can carry out approximately 2 to 3 ampere current, and that is enough current for 5 ampere circuit. Means there is no application design in 5 ampere circuit which can cross the limit of 2 ampere consumption. So whenever there is more than 2 ampere current will flow, it will immediately act. So keep this in mind, but it having disadvantages. Now let's move on. For that purpose we select the cartridge type fuse. Now understand this, the fuse element is enclosed in totally enclosed container and is provided with metal contacts on the both side. Means this fuse element is totally enclosed, no any environmental effect like rise in temperature or humidic nature can, we know that it will create different type of impacts on our conductors that can be limited by totally enclosed type fuse. So in which cartridge type, we have D type cartridge fuse. It is non-interchangeable fuse comprising a fuse base, adapter ring, cartridge and fuse cap. Second type is high rupturing capacity, where large concentration of power are concerned. As in modern distribution system, it is essential that the fuse should have a definite known breaking capacity, and also the breaking capacity should have high value. So this is for higher voltage related, but it is in also low voltage, there is 15 ampere applications there we can use it. So this is the basically structure, totally enclosed body to metallic contacts outside. So this is the fuse. Normally you can observe this fuse nowadays in your UPS, small battery backup units, inverters or TV sets. There we can see this HRC type fuse, and this is the D type fuse, which is totally enclosed body, which having a high capacity rupturing current, rupturing capacity. So what inside it is the fuse element, then outer element, fuse link, filling powder. This filling powder is for helpful for arc quenching purpose. Okay, so we can use a quartz powder as a fuse filling powder. And next thing is brass element. So this is the structure of HRC type fuse, or we can say cartridge type fuse. Okay, next type is D type fuse. Basically this type of fuse is used where we need a double type of protection, means where element will going to break the circuit, but same time because of gravity the handle at this area will get the contact separated in means their contact gap will be more, or we can say the melting of fuse cause the element to drop under gravity about its lower support and additional isolation, means it provide additional isolation. Striker fuse, it is a mechanical device having enough force and displacement which can be used for closing tripping indicator circuits, means it will be act very fastly and physically they will move the two contacts from each other. So now switch fuses, like we know that there are nowadays very, too many electronic components having very sensitive components inside. So because of switching surges, it can create impact on that circuit or make damage some small electronic component inside. So if this type of surge will be created, it will be compensated immediately in that switch. So for that purpose we use switch fuses. Now we will see high voltage HRC fuses, high rupturing capacity fuses. So cartridge fuse, again we know that what is the cartridge fuse. Basically the totally enclosed body having two metallic terminal outside through which we can connect that cartridge fuse in series and fuse. Next thing is liquid type high voltage HRC fuse. These fuse are filled with carbon tetrachloride and have the widest range of application. So basically this type is of fuse is used with the filling of carbon tetrachloride, which quench, we know that carbon is very good to, for arc quenching purpose, and the result of that we can control the circuit up to 400 ampere rating and 132 kV or higher maybe. Also the arc quenching capacity of this is, or short circuit current quenching capacity is 6100 ampere. So this is the very huge current which is normally we are never going to face in residential or low voltage applications, but in high voltage applications or circuits like transmission lines or different big size industries, there the current may be very high up to 400 ampere. There we can use this type of fuses, and also for transformers. So it is for 33 kV transformer, it is suitable up to 33 kV transformers with 350 MVA 3 phase capacity transformers, that also can we can control through this liquid type fuse. Now till these fuses, they are all non-automatic types fuses, means once they operated we have to do something to in a cartridge type fuse we have to replace total fuse, full fuse. In rewirable fuse we know that we have to use replace the element, fuse element of that fuse. So nowadays we know that we are very conscious about the time lag or the operating period of the fuse, and that's why here we can see MCB type fuse. This is also fuse, but we called it as a MCB, that means miniature circuit breaker. It is commonly used for low voltage electrical network instead of fuse. It is automatically, so here is the word very important, automatically means it will operate automatically without any instruction from anyone. It will sense the circuits in different way. There have two ways to sensing the circuit. One is by sensing its temperature, means thermal effect. Thermal effect means when the current will rise, it will rise the temperature of the metallic strip, or and that temperature can be sensed by this MCB and it will get tripped. Also second thing is common, electromagnetic principle working, that we will discuss in detail. So how MCB is construction constructed? MCB means miniature circuit breaker. Construction is very simple, robust and maintenance free. The miniature circuit breaker has normally three main constructional part, frame of miniature circuit breaker. This is the outside body which is called as frame. This frame of MCB is molded case. This is rigid, strong, insulated housing in which the other components are mounted. Okay. Operating mechanism of miniature circuit breaker. Operating mechanism means this knob and the structure connected with the knob. I will explain it later. The operating mechanism of MCB provide the means of manual of opening and closing operation of miniature circuit breaker. And very important, why we use the MCB is because of this trip unit of miniature circuit breaker. The trip unit is the main part responsible for proper working of miniature circuit breaker. So one by one we will discuss again this. There are two arrangement of operation of miniature circuit breaker. I have already told you that in faulty condition, in normal condition. In normal condition, with this knob we can on turn it on or off. In our laboratory also we have MCB, ALCB installed, and we observe that many times that when we need to turn it on, we just push the knob, and when we need to turn it off, we have to press one button, that total contact will get immediately disconnected. And this immediately disconnection is because of due to electromagnetic effect. We know that if I will take this solenoid with the multiple cores, copper conductors are wounded on it, so it will create some magnetic induction which will be attract the contact, and that's why it will keep that attraction until there is presence of current. Okay, so this is the electromagnetic induction which is we are using basically to keep the MCB in working condition. So what will happen when there is some abnormal situations, we have to face some abnormal conditions like overcurrent. So that time we have this bimetallic strip, and also these clutches, arc clutches. So first thing, this arc bimetallic strip which will sense the temperature of this MCB, and if it will be higher, we know that bimetallic strip will get bent and it will disconnect from the main contact. So this is one type of operation. In second type of operation, which is achieved when the bimetallic strip continues over the current flow through MCB, bimetallic strip heated and deflate by bending. So this is the bimetallic strips working. Again, if there is a higher current, then we know that there may be possibility of very high spark can be created because of arc quenching, and these arc clutches will just distribute this arc in different areas, and that's why the quantity of arc get distributed and it will not create any harm to the devices. Okay, so this is how this MCB will work. So advantages of this is the automatic type fuse, rest of all are non-automatic type fuse. Why this is automatic type fuse? Because we can just turning the switch on or knob to on condition and it will start working again. Means after operation we don't have to replace anything or we don't have to do anything, we just have to press that knob. Okay, now the advantages of fuse: it is the cheapest form of protection available, it needs no maintenance, it interrupts enormous short circuit current without noise, flame, gases or smoke, because all things are calculated, the current rating is already displayed on the their configuration. So if we will use it as per their configuration, there is no harm or any chance of gas, flame or smoke. The minimum time of operation can be made much smaller than that with the circuit breaker. The smaller size of fuse element imposes a current limiting effect under short circuit. The inverse time current characteristic enable its use for overload protection. Disadvantages of fuse: considerable time is lost in rewiring or replacing a fuse after operation, but that is also eliminated in MCB. The current time characteristic of fuse cannot always be correlated with that of the protected devices. The on heavy short circuit, discrimination between fuse in series cannot be obtained unless there is considerable differences in the relative size of the fuse concerned. So these are the few disadvantages also we have. So this is enough for chapter number 6.